Hello, everyone. Hope you're having a wonderful day. I just want to talk about homelessness for a second. It's for some reason, it's ignored. It's shunned or it's looked down upon when it's basically it's my problem. It's your problem. I mean, especially my problem because I'm concerned. I'm one of them. But the point is, it's everybody's concern because everybody that is homeless is a part of the world. They're a part of us. You can't ignore their existence. You can't ignore their suffering, their pain. It's not something we can do. It is daily. I was thinking earlier about a tragic incident that happened to me when I was in San Francisco. I mean, I was so jazzed to be there. I was like super jazzed. It was early in the morning, like 6:30. The city was waking up, and I was in the business district, and I walked all the way around to the bridge pretty much all day long. It was awesome. But this one point that broke my heart was this poor homeless lady. She was like older, maybe 40s, and just covered in shit, like literally. I didn't want to get into it, but it was just, and I was just like, and she was walking down, she was in front of me walking in the direction I was going. And I was just amazed that everybody was ignoring her. And obviously she was mentally ill. And it was just, I felt so bad. But she was, you looked in her eyes and she was not there. And I'm like, I wish there was somebody that could have like helped. I don't even know how you help somebody in that situation. Because I was like, what could I do? And I was like, I looked at her, oh, she would, yeah. It's like sometimes someone's like waking somebody that's sleepwalking. You don't know how they're going to react to an interaction with somebody when they might be in a whole different realm, you know what I mean? It's like, it's sad, but anyway, that broke my heart. But anyways, being in courts is an interesting situation, and I just wanted to, you know, and I noticed there's a lot of people traveling, and a lot of people, you know, and it's, they call it full-time traveling, but, you know, it's just like a soft euphemism for, you know, homelessness. That's all it is. And what it comes down to is people are struggling, and I'm telling you, in the span of 2 years, I went from looking at an industry where I was going to get rich to me living in my vehicle. I'm not even kidding. The span of 2.5 years. All because of, you know, politics and control. And they implemented this really, it was like, the fact that it was just so smooth and these people are just getting away with so much right now is just bizarre. It's like reality doesn't exist. You know, surreality versus reality, that kind of thing. It's like, whatever you want to perceive it as good, the good is bad and the bad is good. It's bizarre as hell, but I guess if you control the narrative, you control the, you know, everything else, I guess. That's which is sad because we all live together. We all should, you know, well, those, unless you're super rich and you don't live in the same world that we live in, but you don't struggle and suffer and go without. But anyway, I love you. God loves you and the universe loves you. And we're going to win this. I mean, look what God gave us, right? It's beautiful. We're going to win. These people, I mean, it's just a matter of time. You know, the fools shall fall. And then the rest of us will be raised up and have fun and live our lives and work hard and love and laugh and be merry, right? Anyway, I love you. Have a wonderful day. And good luck with everything. And I'll talk to you later.